Hello and welcome back to theCUBE. My name is Paul Nashwadi. We're here on the show floor at KubeCon and Cloud Native Con in London. And we're here to talk about a whole slew of things with Pure Storage and Portworx. I'm here today joined by Steve and Venkat. How you doing, guys?
Hey, Paul, good to be here.
Great to have you here, great to have you back on the show.
Absolutely. It's
great to have you. Steve, why don't you give the audience a little bit about an introduction of who you are and what you do?
Sure, yeah, I'm Steve Lewis. I work for HSBC. My role is the global lead for container platforms engineering at HSBC, so we're running the internal on-premise container platform services, both a heritage PCF platform and our strategic Kubernetes platform.
So this show is not relevant at all?
No, not at all, indeed.
Yeah, Venkat, why don't you give the audience a little bit about your background?
Absolutely, I've been in Cube many times. I am the GM for the Portworx business unit inside Pure. You know, and we're like working with customers like Steve and HSBC and a lot of other global 2000 customers.
Well, welcome back. We definitely love you have you on the show. It's great. You know, the event, there's a lot happening here. Kubernetes, it's the right technology for a lot of organizations, but it's also a challenge for a lot of organizations. You know, what we see here at the event, whether it was at the keynote or just walking the show floors, there's a ton going on with regards to cloud native and optimization and modernization. So Steve, I'm going to jump right into it. Why is Kubernetes the right technologies for HSBC?
Sure. I mean, I think, you know, with the optimization resources, trying to get more out of the technology, improving utilization, we're seeing improvements of at least 50% in terms of the value we get out of the resources we invest in a platform like Kubernetes compared to traditional technologies. So yeah, it's a way of getting kind of more bang for our bucks. And yeah, I mean, we think 50% more.
So 50% more utilization, optimization, what about that?
Value, I suppose.
Value
through a combination of higher utilization and just more cost efficient. I mean, the platform has less overheads inherently.
So yeah. So when it comes to that optimization piece, what were you coming from?
I guess the hardware itself, we're exploiting more of the hardware, there's less overhead in the platform. You've only got one OS being shared by multiple containers instead of multiple copies. And just the management overhead of that, right? Managing multiple copies of an operating system compared to managing just containers, workloads, and your developers are freed up from a lot of that platform overhead, so yeah.
Absolutely.
And we run our container platforms, our on-prem container platform, as namespace as a service. So we're getting a lot of sharing out of the underlying platform.
Yeah, and Venkat, modernization is the trend, not the trend, but it is the top of mind for most CIOs that I talk to. How is Portworx helping with this?
Yeah, absolutely. So like, you know, as you heard what Steve say, right? I mean, what they are trying to do is to go from the legacy pinned workloads to specific hardware to create a shared services model on which multiple application teams can have a shared platform, right? So, you know, that delivers a lot of cost optimization, a lot more efficiency, right? And it makes software development a lot more faster, right? So, but all of this comes, if you have legacy mindset or legacy process, you cannot really take advantage of the modernization initiatives, right?
True.
So, in order for app modernization to work, you have to have a complete self-service model where developers can build, ship, and run their code everywhere, and then be able to kind of like iterate pretty fast on, you know, going from dev to production and back and iterate again, right? So, where Portworx really shines is delivering that kind of self-service capability for all the data-intensive production apps, right? Especially, and there is no real mission-critical app if it doesn't have data.
Right.
And HSBC being a bank, of course they have a lot of mission-critical data. They have a lot of data that needs to be secured. There's a ton of, that application that needs to be built on it to serve their internal and external customers, right? So Portworx enables HSBC, or customers like HSBC, to deliver self-service for their Kubernetes environments, for, you know, automates their entire workflow completely, you know, like doing storage for like a few nodes, a few servers is hard enough. But at the scale someone like HSBC runs is tens of thousands of nodes. And imagine having to deliver services at that scale So you need to have a sophisticated level of automation in the data management platform, which is what Portworx provides, right?
Yeah.
The third important thing is, look, I mean, nobody is just pinned to the data center. You know, banks like HSBC and others like have, you know, like a presence on multiple data centers, on clouds potentially, right? So architecting with Portworx gives them that neutrality, that now they are built on Portworx and Kubernetes, so they can build and operate it everywhere, right?
Yeah.
So that's kind of what we help, how we help the modernization move.
Yeah, I love the story. I mean, I've sat through many, as you know, many of briefings with Pure and Portworx, and you know, your value proposition of bridging the gap between old and new is also a very strong value proposition.
Yeah.
But absolutely optimizing on the next generation, the new containerization and such. Steve, I want to talk a little bit about some of the applications, right? Can you give some examples of Kubernetes and what's happening at HSBC with Kubernetes applications and specifics?
Sure. We, on the internal Kubernetes platform that I run, we're hosting something in excess of 600 production services.
Wow.
Each one of comprised of many applications and workloads. What's that? That's 13,000 nodes, I think, on more than 200 clusters. So it's a big operation, including both production and non-production. A good example of one of those that's really critical to the bank is our payments systems. We have regulated payments services running in multiple jurisdictions around the world. That, you know, that payments is considered a nationally critical infrastructure in many jurisdictions, and
sure,
it's very heavily regulated. So we are looking for very high reliability. We cannot take any risks for those platforms. And the throughputs are huge. I mean, we're talking about millions of transactions and trillions of payments. So yeah, it's a very big deal to us. Reliability and integrity of the data and our ability to survive any kind of incident and know that the data is intact is absolutely critical.
Well, of course, and governance, compliance, and regulations makes a lot of sense. I mean, so but can you double click down a little bit onto some of the challenges you were faced with? We early went like searching for a new Kubernetes data management platform. What were some of the challenges that you had to overcome before you actually implemented?
Well, simplistically, you've got storage and you're trying to connect to the storage from a workload. And you know, for a large workload that needs to be able to scale, we need rewrite many capabilities. Read-write once is not enough.
Right.
Even if we just had one instance of a process, you've got to be able to survive the restart of a process or the proactive start of another copy, and you've got to be able to retain the integrity of that data through that. So you need read-write many, and that was the basic reason we got into Portworx in the first place. But that's just, if you like, price of entry. It's the basic requirement. Once you've got there, there's more value in the platform itself. So you've got, you know, the backup capabilities, the DR capabilities, the replication, all that kind of stuff. So yeah, it's a platform on which we can build, and importantly, although we use Pure Storage, right? We're not tied into Pure Storage, so that's also important. We're not tied into, you know, a particular flavor of Kubernetes, and we're not tied into a particular flavor of storage.
Yeah, and so like when I hear what you just said, there's a lot of challenges I hear about, you know, Kubernetes and such, and in general I see the number one thing that organizations are trying to do is modernize. They hit the challenges are basically complexity and skill gap issues, right? And it sounds like the complexity piece was resolved. I mean, it's Venkat, you want to talk a little bit about that? Because I know that Portworx is, that almost, I don't want to call it the big green button, the easy button, but it's pretty easy to do the deployment.
Yeah, absolutely, right? I mean, look, like any customer, HSBC started out as like a few hundred nodes, and very quickly they grew to 12,000 nodes. And I just took a selfie with Paul and our account manager. It's like, and Steve and Kerry, our account manager, and Paul Brown, our CSM, you know, say like, you know, look how far we have come in a short time, right? So once, you know, it is important that when you are a platform, you know, we integrate with the customers' processes. That's the key thing.
Yeah.
See, a lot of folks have built, you know, bespoke or like, you know, products that for specific use cases, but the customers have to change their workflows to integrate them.
Sure.
Instead, what we do in Portworx is that we work with the customers' workflow and integrate our product into theirs, so it's easy for them to adopt and operate at scale, right?
Yeah. Meet the client where they are.
Exactly,
yeah.
Right? So, and the fact that, you know, we are built as a fully integrated piece of the Kubernetes control plane, we run in the worker nodes, We give a Kubernetes experience to all of the operators and all of the folks who operate the clusters, and the developers also get the complete Kubernetes experience of self-service. So it's easy to deploy and scale as well, right?
Yeah.
And we aren't stopping here, we're just getting started. As Steve mentioned about the payment platform, it processes hundreds of trillions of dollars of transaction in a year, and they've only made it available in a few sets of countries, so it's going to be expanded more, and there's more other services. So this is going to continue to expand, and there is a huge movement around, hey, how do you run bare metal containers? And I think HSBC is leading the thought on that as well. And I'll let Steve talk more about it.
Yeah, Steve, absolutely. I was going to pivot over. I want to ask about the benefits and the results that you saw. You went with Portworx. It was the right choice for your solution. It seemed to move right in the right direction. What was some of the results after the adoption?
Well, I guess importantly, the performance we get good performance out of the platform, but as we move to bare metal, we're seeing even more performance. And there are pressures in the market, shall we say, encouraging people to look at bare metal rather than virtualized technology. We use the Google's Anthos or GDC on-prem version of Kubernetes,
yep.
And that runs on both VMware and on bare metal. As we start to push the boundaries, we're starting to experience the pains of growth, the scale, right? We're talking about thousands of developers, we're talking about hundreds of services, and it's hard work, right? We're operating namespaces of service, that's a shared platform, we've got challenges. One of our biggest challenges right now is the maintenance of that platform, the constant flow of upgrades. New versions of Kubernetes are coming out every 4 months, and we've got to keep pace, right? And we've got to get that upgraded. And on an estate the size that we have, 200 plus clusters, that's like painting the fourth road bridge, right? It never ends. We're constantly upgrading, maintaining. And I think that's where, for example, one of those value-added services we've been able to leverage from Portworx is the Portworx backup feature. So, one of our challenges is if we get behind, right, you've suddenly got this backlog of upgrades, and it's starting to build, and it's not just the Kubernetes kind of platform itself, but it's all the ancillary components as well. When you're adding into that, the service mesh and all the ingress controller, it starts to become quite a big overhead. Clearing that backlog, Google have made it a little easier. We can now skip a version,
yep.
But we can't skip multiple versions. And what we're looking at doing now with Portworx is using Portworx backup to leapfrog multiple versions and kind of create a solution for problems that, it's a business problem,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
We're regulated, we've got to ensure that things are kept up to date, and we've got to be able to catch up, and yeah, Portworx has got solutions for that.
Yeah, and there's table stakes in the industry. There's obviously technologies that can do it, and where we look at Portworx adds those above and beyond pieces, and those are the pieces I think that really help accelerate the project. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, absolutely, right? I mean, that's why, Steve mentioned, it's a platform, that's just music to my ears, right? So you're, one of your top customers kind of really call out what's your value add, right? The Portworx is a complete platform, right? So, we built this because we started out as a kind of a storage for containers, but then we quickly realized customers need automation,
right?
So we built, things like Stark and Autopilot. Then we realized customers need disaster recovery. So we built the Portworx DR and migrate capabilities, where you can not just do DR, you can do complete stateful app migrations between blue-green clusters, on-prem to cloud, cloud back to on-prem, because customers have different changing workflow needs, right? And then we said, okay, you know what? Now, as folks were deploying Kubernetes clusters in production, they needed a way to get resiliency, cyber resiliency for Kubernetes, right? Which was non-existent when we started out, right? So, because we saw a lot of customers bet their businesses on Kubernetes, and they said, let's move with Portworx Backup, right? But so what Portworx Backup does is that it builds a catalog of your entire Kubernetes infrastructure. All of, for example, in Steve's case, the 200 clusters he has, the app bindings, the service bindings, the configurations, all the config maps and secrets, and then of course the data goes along with it. And then kind of it builds a time machine for your Kubernetes cluster. You can continue to snap all of your infrastructure, store it into a object store, catalog it, or even a file backend, and then continue to do that, right? And then he's able to leverage that to restore it, and then migrate workloads within clusters as well. So
it's fantastic. It sounds like there's a bright future. It sounds like it's the right decision. It sounds like you made the right decision moving to Portworx. I want to thank you both for your time today. This has been great, very insightful. I want to thank the audience for your time watching, and we'll be back.